I finally watched the Great British Bake Off's Mexican Week, and here's my recap of this horrible, horribly offensive episode. The episode kicks off as offensively as humanly possible with these two bozos dressed in Mexican costumes from the spirit store. It immediately goes downhill from here as they engage in the cringiest banter ever.
Hello, I don't feel like we should make Mexican jokes. People will get upset.
What, no Mexican jokes at all?
I don't think so.
What, not even Juan?
Not even Juan.
Welcome to the Great British Baking Show.
Everything about this episode was comically offensive, starting with the first challenge, which was to make pan dulce. The bakers were naturally inspired by Mexican stereotypes, and they decorated their conchas to look like cacti and corn, because according to one baker, Mexicans love corn.
I'm making corn in a cob, pan dulce. Corn is very popular in Mexico.
One baker did his Duolingo lessons, and when he realized that concha was Spanish for shell, he created a very literal representation of a shell, complete with a pearl and oyster.
It's like based on a shell, so I'd kind of stick with that theme.
Then these two, who represent clear opposite ends of the hair spectrum, came back with some more cringy banter.
So is Mexico a real place?
I think so.
What?
I think it's like Xanadu.
Like Oz?
Yeah, like Cleethorpes.
Okay.
At first I was like, why would Brits think that Mexico is imaginary? And then I was like, oh, it's because Spain beat them at colonizing it. Which, shout out to Spain. If we had to be colonized by any European nation, I'm glad it was you guys. It's not that I'm pro-colonizer, but after watching this episode, I'm really glad we were not colonized by Britain. Then they moved on to the technical challenge, which was making tacos. Yes, a baking show had the contestants making tacos. Join me in part two when we get to the taco challenge.
So then we get to the taco technical challenge. And this is where I realized that watching British people in distress is the most hilarious thing ever. Because nothing was more distressing to this group of bakers than the prospect of making tacos from scratch. Which, by the way, the tacos must be made from yellow field corn, and on top should have steak, spicy refried beans, guacamole, and pico de gallo.
But first you gotta hear these two connoisseurs of Mexican cuisine describe what the taco should entail.
Got a pico de gallo, which is basically a salsa.
Pico de gallo.
Steak, then a little bit of cheese, and also refried beans.
That's it, it does look good.
The refried beans and the taco.
Getting the taco right. The big things in Mexico when you're having a taco is it's lovely to have a lot of filling on it, but it has to be practical as well. So you should be able to encase it and then eat it.
Yeah.
If it's too much, it's going to go everywhere.
Okay, there's never a problem if a taco has too much filling. We just get another tortilla and make another taco. So they start by making the tortillas, and I have never seen tortillas made this way, but they basically take drained, like, canned corn, blend it into a paste, and then mix it with masa harina.
It is for the tortillas. Blend the drained corn until you have a smooth, thick paste.
Tip the processed corn out onto a wet surface and add masa harina, then mix to form a dough.
Masa harina. I think it's like corn flour.
I love how redundant this recipe is between using corn paste and masa harina to make tortillas. It's the same thing! So then they move on to making the steak and the marinade for the steak, which incorporates lots of spices that these Brits just cannot handle.
Ground cumin, small paprika, dried oregano.
Oregano?
Professor, I am flinging things into a bowl with gay abandon.
With what
Anto
abandon?
Chili powder.
So Anto tortilla powder is dangerous, so we will be going
no,
using
it's not.
My chili is not too hot.
Ooh, look at her snorting the spices.
Something missing.
How do you know something's missing? You don't know Mexican
I'm
cuisine.
I'm gonna sneeze inside.
Salud.
Excuse me.
What's pico de gallo?
Pico de gallo.
Interesting. Pico de gallo. This is the first time I've heard them. I think pico means small, maybe.
Then they moved on to the guacamole, and this is where I lost it, watching her peel the avocado with a knife. So now they gotta make the refried beans, and I lost it again because they're making refried beans Rachel Ray style by starting with a can of beans. Yo, they absolutely struggled with these beans.
Salt, black beans.
I don't think it's supposed to be hot. And in this one,
no, it's actually not supposed to be hot.
I think that's what refried beans looks like.
I'm speechless. I've never seen refried beans that look like this. Finally, they move on to pressing and cooking the tortillas, and some struggled more than others with this challenge.
So
now they have to assemble the tacos, and you think they were assembling IKEA furniture without the instructions, the way they overcomplicate this very simple task. Girl, that's too much meat. Like, the guacamole first? The guacamole?
My pico de gallo is a bit spicy.
No, it's not. So then the masters of Mexican cuisine come out to judge the tacos. The tortilla master has notes. Okay, girl, that's burnt. You burnt the tortilla. I cannot take these judges seriously.
Because you really want to get it all in at once, don't you?
That's what he said? I don't like watching her eat tacos.
That's ridiculous, do you think?
That's what my ex said about my... If you want to know who won this technical challenge, none of them did. They all failed. Join me for part three, where we get to the pasta de tres leches challenge. For the final challenge, the bakers are tasked with making a tres leches cake. So vampire Dudley Moore and this human claymation figure explain to the bakers that their tres leches cakes must have at least 4 layers. I was so glad my edible kicked in before they got to this part of the episode, because when I heard 4 layers of tres leches cake, I was like, immediately, no. You can't do that. You can't stack tres leches cake. Like, I don't understand the thought process behind whoever thought up this challenge. They were like, oh, well, there's 3 milks. Let's make it 4 layers. What? You don't stack tres leches cake. So the virtuosos of Mexican baking techniques come out and explain the perfect soak for their tres leches cake.
What it mustn't do is to so soak up the cake that the milks are running out of the bottom.
Like, it's fine if there's milk around the sides of the cake. No pasa nada. I don't understand why they're being so unnecessarily anal about how much filling is in a taco or how much soak is in the sponges of the cake. Like, relax, y'all. It's not that deep. So then the bakers explain their concepts for the cakes to the judges, and I am immediately concerned for how many of them mentioned curds.
Abdul's cake will be soaked in passion fruit and coconut tres leches, have lime curd filling, and be adorned with white chocolate sugar skull.
His dragon fruit cake will have a guava and coconut milk soak, mango cream and dragon fruit, and passion fruit curd.
Like, do they know that tres leches means 3 milks? Citrus doesn't go with that. Okay, so then the contestant that made the corn on the cob pan dulce, she was inspired by the only association with Mexico she knows, and she decided to make, well, I'll let her explain.
Here has opted for the unconventional.
I am making sweet corn sponge.
Explain.
It's a sponge that I put a little bit of sweet corn in.
Why would you want that in a cake?
Why not?
I like the idea of it.
Well, it's very Mexican. And it might
actually
work.
It is. Sis just discovered pan de elote. Some ideas were interesting.
After another set of poor performances, Rebs is determined to deliver a winner.
So I am doing a tiramisu tres leches wedding cake. So it's a wedding cake to symbolize the marriage between an Italian classic and Mexican flavors.
Okay. One of the bakers is undertaking the task of creating a temple out of his 4 layers of tres leches cake.
Despite this, Kevin is undertaking a vast geometric construction.
My tres leches sponge will be soaked in coffee milk, and I'll be building it in 4 square tins to make an Aztec pyramid temple.
Mayan or Aztec?
Well, there's a bit of overlap, really, isn't there?
No! The Aztec and Mayan civilizations are separated by like thousands of years. You know what? We're not going to get into that right now. So now the bakers have moved on to stacking the cakes. And again, watching British people in distress is hilarious.
It's now the bakers find out if they have one of 2 very different problems.
Oh, this is a stressful problem.
If their sponge is too wet, it's at risk of collapse.
Cake soaked the full way through, kind of what I hoped for.
Too dry, and it could fail to deliver the sumptuous tres leche eating experience.
I don't think it's soaked at all.
Ah, it's not centered. Ah, yes, what happened. But do you know what? Go hard or go home.
Oh,
I just don't want it to collapse.
The cake itself, it didn't soak well.
I cry. Yeah, I'm gonna cry.
Don't cry. It's not that deep,
right.
Bro.
It's gonna be alright.
It's just okay? Cake.
I'm gonna pull this off. The flavors are gonna be amazing.
Building a multi-layered cake with soaked sponges is a construction conundrum.
Yeah, because you're not supposed to stack the sledges.
My chocolate cake split at the bottom, and now it's leaking everywhere. I just don't understand why it's turned out like this. I'm going to try and cover it up with icing.
It's very difficult to, like, get it, like, it's not working out that well.
Yeah, because
why is it so bulged this side? Oh my goodness, I'm going to cry. I'm just going to get the cream.
It's a mess. Not good.
I'm so friggin' stressed out right now.
So how did the cakes turn out? Join me in, I guess, part four, where I'll finish this up. Okay, so this is our final part in the Great British Baking Show Mexican Week episode recap. Before we get into the results of the Pastel de Tres Leches final challenge, let's just recap all the offensive banter between the hosts of the show.
I might be Mexican in my soul. Fruit earrings. I'll give them back to
her.
Yeah, please.
Oh, do you want to hear my Mexican accent?
Yes, please.
All right, here we go. Arriba! You are halfway through. What do you reckon?
It's really good.
Thank you.
Okay, so let me get this straight. Mexico is a real place.
Yeah.
How would one get there?
Oh, it's easy. You just go like this.
Well, that's all well and good for him, but
I can't
do that.
Get it? Because it's south of the border?
Makers, you have 1 hour left.
Okay, so the first cake that the judges judge is the sweet corn inspired pastel de tres leches.
Let's have a look. I think the soak's a bit dry on a couple of them. The top two seem to be wetter than the bottom.
I agree.
Such a surprise. It tastes like sweet corn.
She made pan de elote. I'm convinced of that.
I mean, we ask you to be imaginative. Well, that is imaginative.
It's not for me.
My only quarrel is I think it would have been better not to have the lumps of corn.
But that's what you have in pan de elote. One of the bakers made a chocolate and lime many leches cake. What do you mean many leches? Like, they only asked for three.
I think overall you attempted too much. None of it's neat.
Because you told them to
do all
that.
The Frasier cake needs to be much neater than that. The collar
is
lost all
shine. It's
tres leches.
It can't be neat.
The pipework isn't particularly good. I have a few issues with this.
It is a bit untidy.
I have a few issues with this show.
Let's see what it tastes like.
Actually, it looks good. It looks wet. That's a whop. Wet as pastel.
The cake layer is absolutely delicious.
I like the flavour of the Fraser tart. Creaminess, the lightness, the sort of vanilla. The top sponge is a little bit tough. Much drier than the bottom one.
Because all the milk fell to the bottom.
Like,
what did you expect was going to happen with four layers of this? So then we get to the pyramid cake and it looks like a child's school project. What is this? Like, look at the designs on that. That looks like something you'd see on Nailed It.
Some of the milky syrup is running out.
It's supposed to.
Must mean it's quite well soaked. Maybe
over-soaked. No such thing as over-soaked.
It's fantastic. And to make it in tres leche cake is tricky. I think you pulled it off all right. What's that in the bottom? Is that just where the milk's haven't soaked in?
I reckon there's probably a few parts where it's not soaked in.
I love the flavour. It's got a little bit of a kick. Quite a kick. It's strong chilli.
Added chilli to the cake?
The biggest issue I have is the texture.
Straight to jail.
You've got flour lumps in there.
That's a real pity because flavor's good.
No, it's not. In fact, a few other contestants also put chili in their cakes.
Have you got chili in there?
Yeah, in the ganache. Is it too strong?
When it comes to aesthetics, I thought this cake was like the nicest looking cake. I just think fruity horchata tres leches cake, like there was nothing horchata about this cake. I think he just like wanted to incorporate a Mexican thing that he happened to know. One of the bakers was inspired by Day of the Dead, and the concept for this cake, it was there, but this is why you don't stack tres leches. It's collapsing. It looks like the Leaning Tower of Pisa. I am so confused by this cake because, you know, the whole idea was that they were supposed to be inspired by Mexican icons. Who was he inspired by when he made this cake? Pancho Villa's mustache? Of all the cakes, this one felt the most racist to me. This cake also had chili in it, and the judges, they're not liking the chili. Or maybe it's that they can't handle it.
I know we're always asking for good, strong flavors, but I think you've overdone it a bit, Sandra. There's too much booze, too much chili.
Oh yeah, he added tequila to this too. So how did the tiramisu tres leches cake come out? Bad. It came out bad.
That is very boozy.
She also added tequila to it.
Ganache.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's supposed to be mellowed by the cream.
Filling is too much. A little less tequila and quite a lot less chili.
Oh, Lord.
This cake looked the most practical of the tres leches cakes, because if this is four layers, they're very modest size four layers. This is the cake that the judges really liked, and one judge liked it too much.
That flavor is heaven.
Look at the way he's looking at her. He just fell in love. The winner ended up being Maxie with her Party City cake, complete with balloons, because those are Mexican. If it were up to me, I would say that nobody won. I certainly didn't win anything watching this other than lots of stress and anxiety. Join me for apparently they made s'mores and fucked that up too. Am I gonna have to watch that episode too? Let me know if I should make a recap of the American Week episode of Great British Baking Show.